Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel. And in this video, I am going to show you how you can learn and master UISwitch programmatically in Swift. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, let me just show you what are we going to build out today by running our test. And I would just hide this so you don't get a peek, but only what we are going to build out. So here is our UISwitch created programmatically in Swift. And as you can see, it has some custom features that we will learn how to do in this tutorial. So let us just close this, and we are going to do this from scratch. So let us just create a new Xcode project, and I will choose the single view app that I have created. Go ahead and take a look at my channel for the details, and I will name this, okay, and I will embed it in the navigation controller. It doesn't really matter. Let's just click next, and I will create a Git repository here. And let's put it into our YouTube folder under videos and today's date. And I will create a new folder here called code. And that's that. So let's create it finally. And once this is done, what we need to do is simply close it. Well, that was a funny one. And that is because we are going to use tiny constraints to constrain this switch. So we need to import that through CocoaPods. So what we need to do is navigate to our project here. And there we go. And open up terminal. And type in cd and a space. And what you want to do is drag and drop the root folder of your project into terminal and hit return. Now type in pod in it, and that will create a pod file here, so we can add our pods there. I will open it through Xcode, have the platform to iOS 12, and just simply type in pod tiny constraints. There we go. Let's close this, go back to terminal, and type in pod install. Okay, and that will install the tiny constraint dependency. And what I usually do here is, you see, here we have our latest version, and we'll just configure the pod file. So that will be the latest version that we upload to our project. So there we go. Let us just test it out if this really worked. Let's pod install again. There we go. It is using it. Great. Okay, so from now on, we are going to open up our workspace. So let's do that. And let me resize this so you may see better. There we go. And now we are going to open up our root view controller, and let's create a switch. So lazy var, and I will create a theme switch, because in the next video we are going to create some awesome light and dark themes for your app. So stay tuned for that. Till then, let us just go back to our switch implementation. So, and let's name this theme switch, and it will be of type UISwitch equals. So let, and I'm gonna just copy out this so I don't need to type that out. And it will be UISwitch, and let's return our theme switch. Now that we have that, let's import tiny constraints first, because before we are going to constrain this, let's set our views background color to be white, and for that I am not just going to use the same old white again. Let's go back to Finder, and if you go ahead and click the link down in the description, you will find the way to download the resources for this project. Basically, it's a colors asset. You may want to skip this if you want to, but these are awesome colors. Okay, so I will just simply drag and drop it into there. Make sure copy items if needed is checked and create groups is selected. Also, add to target is checked. Okay, finish, there we go. And inside the colors, we have black, red, and white. So let's use that. And for that, I would just simply hold down Command Shift and select M, and the media library will pop up, and the background color should be white. So with the mouse, I would just simply drag and drop it in there. So there we go, we have our background color. Next up, let us just add our theme switch. So view.add subview and theme switch. And finally, theme switch center in super view, and that is of course with the power of tiny constraints. So let us just build and run and see how this looks at this moment, and then we will customize it, of course. Let's just wait for it. There we go, we have a simple switch, and this is the basic switch that Apple provides. So let's customize this. First of all, let's add a tint color. So tint color equals, and again, Command Shift M, and let's have this tint color to be red. Let's build and run again and see what those changes. And again, you can see that the on tint color is still this green. So let's change that now. Okay, theme swift on tint color on. So let's have this to be red too. Okay, well, we could have anything else, but I really want to create this reddish switch. There we go. Great. Now let's set the thumb tint color too. So theme switch thumb tint color equals, and I will make this black. So let's build and run again and see how that looks like. Great. Okay, so let's see what this looks like if we add in here black. There we go, Command R to build and run again, and let's see how it looks. You can see we have this, let's call it background color, because yes, it is a background color. The background color is actually transparent, and it uses the background of the view. So let's change this background color to be white. Okay, theme switch dot background color equals Command Shift M, and I would just drag and drop this white here, and I would add some spaces so it will compile correctly. So there we go, we have our background color, but now we have all of these not rounded corners. So let's fix that, and that is fairly simple to fix. So theme switch, and there is a layer property underneath that, and we can set the corner radius to 16. So 32 is the basic height of a UI switch, so the corner radius should be 60. Before we build and run, we need to set the theme switches layer masks to bounds. We are going to set that to true. So let's build and run again with Command R, and we should see those rounded corners really, really nicely. There we go. And now that we do have finished that, and we have that out of the way, we can set the background color back to white. However, I do like this black color. Oh, just select the white one. Oh, I need to delete this one first and then select the white one. We are going to theme our app in the next video, so stay tuned for that. So let's build and run again and see we actually don't see this background color, corner radius and mask to bounds if we have a white background, but if we had anything else, that would be pointed out. Great. Now, what we want to do next is the final thing, and that is to add action to this switch. Basically, we are going to add a target. So, team switch, add target, and the target will be self action bound selector, and it will be an Objective-C method, and I will name this team switch, and let's just wait with this naming. Before we do that, let's just add our event. So the event is value changed. So theme switch value, or let's name this did change theme switch and value. So a really good function name. So copy that out and make it an Objective-C function, paste that in there, and now we just simply need to check if our switch is on or off. And for that, I'm just going to create an if statement: theme switch is on, else. So let's just print out switch is on and else switch is off. Okay, and let's build and run one final time, and we should see here in the console that switch is on, switch is off. Great. Okay, now that is it for this tutorial. In the next one, we are going to talk about themes, but let that be the surprise for the next video. Now, if you enjoyed this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell to get notified of new videos as they do come out. Now it is your turn. Go ahead and create your own custom UI switch in Xcode, in Swift, of course, and do let me know how you customized the basic UI switch in the comments down below. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.